Me? I'm relatable?
Hands up in the air. I just want the baddest bitch in the world right here on my lap. And I'ma hit this drink up like it's my last. I'ma hit this night up like it's my last. I'ma like it's my last. Boy. I swear I'ma do it like I never had it at all.
Hey, did y'all like my apples? I just got back from grocery shopping, y'all. Okay, I'm just gonna keep it real. I'm on here today. The day I recorded this is June 9th. This is my fourth day of summer school. I just started on the 6th. And I wanted to get on here, guys, because let me tell you. Silence my phone before I tell you. Life for this past 2 weeks has been life with a capital L. And, you know, I've been talking with my mentors, with my marketing director. I talk to everybody. I'm a talker. If you guys haven't noticed, I just like to talk. All the time. I love to talk to people because it brings me insight and grants me insight into how people think, into how people feel, and it really opens your mind to a plethora of information. And I'll be honest with you guys, until the day before yesterday, it's really nobody's business, but I was flat broke. When I tell you that financial aid is being stipend at schools, when I tell you that book sales right now for me are like this, I know you guys don't believe it because you get on here and you see me in my clothes. You can see this bed behind me. This is my dad's bed, by the way. My dad let me borrow this when I moved out. You know, people see my nails and my hair and they think that I have everything made for myself and everything is given to me and I'm just so perfect and I don't work for anything. Let me tell you right now, that is a load of boo, okay? It's huge, major, untrue fallacies right now. And I hate it. I hate it. I absolutely, positively abhor that people think that my life is given to me. There are days when I struggle just like everybody else. I don't know where this preconceived notion came from, but please find the receipt, take it back to the store, and beg customer service to give you a refund on that boo. Okay? Because it's not true. It's not true. And you know, what I'm basically bringing to everyone's attention today, right now, I know that that's what's affecting my book sales. I know that that's what's intimidating people about me. I know that that's affecting everything of my career at this point. People either think that because I'm 18, I'm incapable, or they're envious of me because I'm 18 because it makes them feel incapable. And let me tell you right now, for everybody that feels that way, that is absolutely pathetic. I have stressed this on all of my videos for people to not be jealous of anybody else and not to be envious of anybody else. And I'll say it in this video again. Because when you become envious of someone else, you are jealous and desiring something that you have no idea about. You don't know what their real life is behind closed doors. Nobody sees me when I'm crying and I'm struggling and I'm actually experiencing hardships as well. Yes, I live in an apartment by myself. Yes, I have my own business. Yes, I'm in college early and I have these great things going for myself, but I'm constantly working to maintain that. I work to get here. Even though my family, my dad, put me in the position, I have to do my own schoolwork. I have to keep these bills paid here. I do all my own grocery shopping. I work out 3 times a week. I had to take on the burden and the responsibility of the career path that I chose for myself, how hard it is to defy these stereotypes, how hard it is for people to respect me, how hard it is for me to beg people not to be envious of me. These are daily struggles and brick walls that Brandalyn Gill has to endure. Before you're jealous of someone else, really do the research and gain some more insight into what you're actually being jealous of. These past 2 weeks have been an exact opposite of what I have been experiencing for the last couple of months. And you guys think it's a joke when I say that all the money coming into my business is going right out. It's funny, but when you really, if you can just focus your mind to understand what people are saying when they say things to you. I know we live in America and we move very quickly. Everything is fast paced, it's instantaneous. But if you just take 1 second to slow your mind down and wrap your head around what people are saying when they say it. I've been making these videos for a year. I researched for a year before I put my book out. It took me 7 years to write my book. I funded my book release party that cost $700 and I didn't even break even on the party. I hustled around U of H and begged the University Center staff to purchase my books. I went door to door and asked these people to pre-order a copy of my book before it was out. Facing possible rejection, facing possible prohibition of my dream. Because if I didn't get the money, the book was not going to be published. No, my grandparents didn't pay for me to be published. No, my dad didn't pay for me to be published. I had a $1,500 of my own personal money that I saved, or grants that I earned from being in school and making good grades, that I footed to print my book. And then after I printed my book, I had to wait months upon months to actually start doing anything with it. I'm not relatable. People cannot relate to me. Let me tell you guys something. Everybody out there watching this video right now, nobody should have to expose their entire life to you. Someone that you perceive to be better than you, that you perceive to not have to experience anything, they should not have to expose their entire life story for you to feel worth something. You should never allow someone to make you feel inadequate. Because if you think about that troublesome conundrum for just 1 second, you will realize that you're the only person that can make yourself feel inadequate, because you're the only person who sets your goals in your life. So therefore, if you feel inadequate up against the success and the possible achievements of someone else, that's your fault, because you didn't set your goals high enough. It's all up to you. It's all up to you. And this is not fake. I am not acting. I'm getting excited and passionate about this because I just can't believe how much of a struggle this is. I really, some days, you guys, I sit back and I think, wow, I am trying to change the fabric of this country with what I'm doing. I'm trying to inspire people. Help people. I'm 18 and I have my own business and I have my own book, and people are not buying it because I don't read, or I can't believe that you did this, so I'm not gonna buy it, or all these excuses. You would think that people just want to buy a book because they want to support that, just because. Who cares? It's $15. But no. But you know what? I'm still grateful for this struggle. I am. I'm on here today to tell you guys that I had to borrow money to pay my rent this month. And I don't care what anybody has to say about that. I'm a struggling artist right now. And you know what? I'm freaking thankful for this struggle right here, right now. You know why? Because all my life I prayed for friends that were true friends. All my life I prayed for this book to be available. Just available. God, I can't tell you how many nights I prayed and I dreamed to have a book. My book that I wrote is available. How many nights I prayed for mentors. And this business, this life that I'm living right now, I told you guys, it was on my dream board. That thing over there, it was there. I planned it and I got it. But you know what, guys? I noticed that people do and that I've been doing is we pray for the good things. We pray for our dreams. But then when we have to struggle, it's a big deal. Oh my gosh, pity party. I didn't want this part. It doesn't work like that. It doesn't. And I've been slapped in the face this week with feeling not like I've been ungrateful, but that, wow, I am grateful. God is still working for me. He still has more things for me to do. I'm grateful for this negative part because look at the positive. I totally had an epiphany this week. I didn't know how I was going to get the money to put the groceries, put these apples in my refrigerator this week. And I walk around and people say, because you're always smiling, Brandy. That's why we don't believe that you go through anything, Brandy. You know, you're not relatable because you don't walk around having a pity party. I'm just like you. Only I made a choice. This is going to be a two-part video, I'm sure. I shouldn't have to do that for anybody. And you know what? If that's what it takes, guys, I will. I'll get on here and I'll tell you what I'm going through, what I'm really going through in the week. You know what? I'll get on here and I'll humble myself. But maybe I will. Because at the end of the day, I need you guys watching me right now to know that I'm here for you. And I don't think people are believing that. I don't think people really realize that I'm here for them. Part 2 is coming.